in towards B, are coming through.
Play that we're talking about here. He's back. He's got no more chances left.
And like I said, if you win that.
One of the sickest players in recent years is definitely Zaewoo. He burst onto the pro scene out of nowhere and straight into the Team Vitality. He's been with them for over 5 years now, and in that time he scooped up 18 MVPs at various tournaments. In 2023 he snagged his first major, and he's never ranked lower than the second on HLTV. So I decided to spill the beans on his settings. To be honest, it was a real challenge, cause he's not much of a media guy and info about his settings is like super scarce online. But after a ton of digging, I finally tracked them down. If you've been on the hunt for his settings, show me some love with a like on this video. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that bell so you don't miss out on more awesome videos. And let's dive in. First off, let's check out Zaewoo's gear and how he's got it set up. His mouse? The Vaxi Outset AX Wireless Orange. Recently this mouse has been a big hit among pro players. The main deal with it is its shape and the fact that it's wireless. As for sensitivity, he's rocking 400 dpi on the mouse with an in-game sensitivity of 2 and the zoom sensitivity of 1. His headphones? The JBL Quantum 910. That's pretty unconventional choice, both among pros and regular games. When it comes to in-game sound settings, there's like zero info about there, but I'm gonna take a wild guess and say that his settings might look something like this. EQ profile, natural. This preset doesn't alter sounds, meaning they reach you totally unprocessed. Left and right isolation, 0%. This gives a strong sense of left versus right. Perspective correction, yes. Sounds at the edge of your field of view will be strongly panned to the left and right. These settings are probably the closest to what you'd hear in CSGO. So Zaewoo runs a pretty standard resolution to 1280 to 960. His monitor is the Zowie XL2566K, a classic choice among pro players. This bad boy can ramp up to a refresh rate over 360Hz, but Zaewoo sticks to 240. Why? So he doesn't feel a difference between playing at home and the tournaments. And he's got the brightness cranked all the way up to 100%. Alright, and let's dive into more of Zaewoo's settings. First up, boost player contrast is enabled. This feature adds a black outline around the character's models, making enemies pop against the map textures. A neat little edge for spotting opponents. Vertical sync is turned off. Why? Because the setting limits your FPS to match your monitor's refresh rate. For instance, if you have a 60Hz monitor and VSync is on, your FPS won't go above 60. Multi-sampling anti-aliasing mode is set to 4x MSAA. This makes the visuals smoother and more pleasing to the eye, preventing the game from looking too harsh. Global shadow quality is cranked to high. This setting is an in-game changer because shadows now respond to all light sources. It means you can spot an opponent by their shadow before they even come into view. Model and texture detail is also on high. This only affects texture quality, which doesn't give a competitive advantage but definitely enhances the visual aspect of the game. Texture filtering mode is set to anisotropic 4x. Like the previous setting, this one just boosts texture quality. Shadow detail is on high. In simple terms, this improves the quality of effects, like the fire from a Molotov cocktail. Particle detail is set to low. It enhances the quality of particles like smoke texture. Since it doesn't offer any visual advantage, it's set to low to save on FPS. Ambient occlusion is on high. Basically, this shading model adds realism to the image by calculating the intensity of light. High dynamic range is set to quality. It controls the brightness range between the brightest and darkest pixels. Fidelity FX super resolution is disabled for the highest quality. NVIDIA reflex low latency is also disabled. It's used to reduce system latency, boosting your PS reaction speed. The boost mode employs methods that can draw more power to the GPU and slightly affect FPS to minimize latency. And now let's jump into the crosshair settings. As of the time of recording this video, this is the latest crosshair info we have that Zaewoo has been using. Crosshair color, 4. Style, 4. Size, 2. Thickness, 0. Gap, minus 3. Dot, 0. This is what it looks like in the game. I'll leave the code for his crosshair in the description below the video. Zywoo's head settings are pretty standard, just like we've all gotten used to. I went into more detail about this one in my previous videos where I talked about the ROB settings. So if you're curious about why pros use this particular view model, you can check out that video. There's a link in the top right corner, but I'll give you a quick recap anyway. View model field of view, 68. View model offset X, 2.5. View model offset Y, 0. View model offset Z, minus 1.5. And view model preset pose, 3. And as always, the last thing you might need from his settings is the radar setup. Radar centers the player, yes. Radar is rotating, yes. Radar hood size, 1. Radar map zoom, 0.7. And toggle shape with scoreboard, yes. That's how Zywoo sets things up. In summary, he does everything to maximize game smoothness and disables anything that might hinder gameplay. Remember, copying his settings won't make you play like him. You need to tailor your settings to suit you, and this video is just to help you find some useful tweaks and general trends. If you like this video, don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to the channel for more cool content. Catch you soon, bye bye!